You are watching Skyrim commentary from Shauna Films.
Okay, so we're leaving. We are leaving. This something moons, whatever it's called. At least that's the plan.
I'd smash your head with my axe.
There's somebody left over? The beauty with OBIS is that there's always some extra bandits nearby. Last night I saw a naked.
Look over there.
A naked.
Go get him. I'm gonna nail him with my axe.
T-pose lady.
That was tough.
She was a bandit. No head, T-pose, naked, running around screaming, trying to kill me, but in T-pose mode, NPCs can't do anything to you because they can't move. And if they can't move, you know, they can run after you, that's all they can do is run after you, but they can't swing their arms. And if they can't swing their arms, they can't hurt you. But then they're a pain in the ass trying to kill. Something about their hit point makes it tougher to hurt them, because they don't have much of a hit point when you're swinging your weapons at them, because they're in T-pose mode. So we still have one of the companions with us, so I'm guessing we're on our way to Dustman's Karn? That's what I want to say. Are we going to go... Maybe we're going to... Maybe we're gonna leave.
I'm not afraid of you.
I wanna say we're gonna leave this area and go to the Redrowyn Retreat. Is that what it's called? I had this companion with me for the longest time. We were going all over the place. Get up. Now you're dead.
Don't you think so?
Never mind, don't get up. Just stay there. Yeah, right across the street here is that other cave, something, something. I thought I saw some bandits over here fighting something, so I thought I'd come take a look-see. I think my mace only works when it's nighttime and the sun is out or something. I forget. Or the nighttime and the moon is out. One of the two. Who's hitting? Who's that guy? That guy just comes out of nowhere.
That was good.
More OBIS.
Right, hand over your valuables, or I will gut you like a fish.
Really?
You're dead.
Someone in this Yostand know when it's time to give up.
I tried to get OBIS to work with lore-friendly adjustments, but it was just so many records that had to be ordered, merged, compared, contrasted with each other to make things copacetic with each other. That's why in this playthrough I decided not to use lore-friendly adjustments, even though that's my favorite. I've said in the past that was my favorite mod of 2000. I want to say either 2018 or 2019.
Don't kill him! Don't kill him! Please.
I can't remember what mod I said was my favorite one of 2019. It was like the first week of January, and I found a mod.
Interfering with official Thormor business.
And already it became my favorite mod of the whole entire year. It probably wasn't lore friendly, it just. I got so many new mods installed now that they're all my favorites. If it's in my mod list, it's probably a favorite of mine, but
now I'm gonna get you.
My favorite mod.
Show me how brave you are.
I can't remember.
Don't even try that.
So I've been playing with the Faiths of Skyrim. It's called Winter Sun. And it's tricky. It's a tricky thing. You have to be faithful, or things don't work out as you plan.
You will be dead. I'm gonna rip you open.
You have to do a lot of praying, you have to do a lot of meditation type stuff. You have to do the things that your deity wants you to do, or your demigod, or whatever they're called. You have to do those things. And if you don't, then you will be abandoned. The god that you worship will just abandon you. It's a really cool mod. You can install it, and then you can use as much as you want of it, or just have it in the background. Just knowing that there's faith in the game now, but you don't have to be faithful to anything. It's just neat having the option to go that path or not with your character as you play. I guess I was taking pictures. Why not? And I thought I saw somebody getting bushwhacked by a giant here. Who was that? I was thinking, oh, I can find their dead corpse on the ground somewhere. Oh, there they are. Yeah, this guy was getting beat up by mammoths and by giants. I've got Skyrim Romance installed. I'm not sure how that works exactly. I've got too many quote-unquote romance mods installed right now. It's like, I want my character to get married early on in this playthrough, so I'd be the dragonborn husband, got the kids, the house, and then Vilya off on the side. I want to see what Vilya does if you're already married. In my last playthrough, I found out what happens if you're romancing Vilya and you decide to get married behind your back. I already found out what happens there. You end up breaking the Vilya mod. So this time I thought, you know what, I'll just get married. And then Vilya will probably make a comment something like, but you're already married. And then that whole romance thing won't even be a thing with Vilya, I'm hoping. We will see. I just haven't decided who to get married to yet. I'm still trying to figure out what my character is before I decide who to get married to for life in the game. In past playthroughs, I've done the divorce mods. I've tried all the divorce mods. Only one of them I can actually use without totally breaking my game. But most divorce mods, you end up breaking NPCs, breaking quests, that kind of thing. Breaking your chances of getting remarried again. It's best not to get divorced in Skyrim. Just pick wisely when you're getting married, because you'll be stuck with that person for a while. Oh, I think you can kill your wife, but then you're just a widow. You don't get to remarry anyone. And you have to resurrect their body and do this special hokey pokey thing if you want to get divorced. And after you kill someone, you can get divorced technically. So you kill your spouse, you bury them somewhere, then you divorce them, and then you're able to remarry without any hitch. I'll have to try that one day. See if that breaks the whole marriage thing. Whoa! I thought that was Velia at first. She just came at me from nowhere.
You are as good as dead.
But the other thing with OBIS that still bugs me is that a lot of the heads on the bodies don't match the colors of the bodies. And to this day, OBIS is still getting endorsements. I don't understand it. Why do people endorse a mod that's half-ass? Maybe the endorsers are half-ass. That explains it. That has to be the explanation. People endorsing the mods are half-ass. Okay, never mind. Forget I even asked the question. I already have the answer. What else has been going on? I went to Reddit. You know, this is other RPG-related stuff. Someone had asked a question, and of course on Reddit, you know, you always have to provide proof of things, so... It's a good thing I have a YouTube channel, so I can make a video explaining what I said when I posted something on Reddit. Because people like to argue with you. They'll say, video or it never happened, kind of thing. So I had to make a video on my channel about a different role-playing game that I play all the time. You know, I don't go around announcing to people, oh, I've been tabletop role-playing since the 70s, blah, 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 blah. I'm not one of those referees or GMs or dungeon masters that says that kind of crap. You know, I've been a... You know the neck beard, the fat neck beard dudes with the fanny packs, they'll say in a heartbeat to you how they've been a dungeon master for D&D for 30 plus years. I wish I had a dollar for every time I hear someone tell me that. Because all I'm hearing is, you're a crappy role player for 30 years. That's all I hear from them when they say that stuff. So I say stuff like, oh, well, this is how I role play. And then they go off the rail. Some guy named Sean Driscoll just shows up out of nowhere and says, this is how I roleplay. It's like I'm just trying to have a conversation with somebody and they go off the rails. Because their religion is about themselves doing this roleplay stuff for 30 plus years and how awesome they are. And then I come along and their world is just crushed or turned upside down. They don't know what to do. They just lose it. They go off the rails. It's real easy to do to people. I don't mean to do it, but... they should know by now that I have a video channel that talks about all kinds of weird roleplay topics. Any subject in roleplay is probably mentioned in my videos. But people have never heard of me, they just think, oh, what is this? Driscoll, you don't even know what you're talking about. And then I say, oh, wait, I have a blog, I have a video thing going on YouTube, and they're like, oh. I try to get people to start up YouTube channels, because they'll say stuff on the blogs and on Reddit, and the first thing out of my mouth is, do you have a YouTube channel? But you know how big fish in a small lake, or big fish in a small pond, you know how they are, right? They don't want the smaller fish to know about YouTube. They like everything being hunky-dory on Reddit, or on a forum somewhere. The minute you mention YouTube, they go into panic mode because they think their followers are gonna bail and go to YouTube and look for inspiration, answers, advice, sage advice from everywhere, from the whole internet, instead of this big fish in a small pond that they've been listening to, thinking, you know, this guy says he's been a dungeon master for D&D for 30 plus years, so he must be super awesome at role playing and just knows everything about everything kind of stuff. He's a guru for D&D nonsense.
Yes? Anytime.
So I find these so-called D&D experts or whatever, role play experts, 30 plus year veteran expert types, whatever. I just mentioned to them, you know what?
Good to see you.
Do honest a YouTube pay video.
For honest work. Honest pay for honest work. Honest pay for honest work. You should buy some produce from Carlotta's.
You know,
stall.
Say, do a YouTube video. And then I watch your YouTube channel and they say, what? YouTube's for losers. They say all this horrible stuff about YouTube, and next thing they know,
Arcadia seems to know a lot about
their all their fans start looking elsewhere, because now they're seeing that they're the guy that they hero worship hates YouTube, and these people probably like watching YouTube people. Anyway. Then it usually goes downhill from there. Once in a blue moon, though, somebody starts a YouTube channel, and I can do video responses to them. They'll do video responses to me. We talk about compare and contrast, you know, compare each other's game styles with each other. That way people watching on YouTube can see, you know, they...
You have come to hear the word of Talos.
Oh, he's talking twice. That was weird. He was saying...
Hi, love.
I had to bump into him because I heard him talking twice.
The Imperial silence us because they fear us.
Like there were two Heimskers. Anyway.
We are the children of man. Talos.
But yeah, if there's two people talking about subjects on YouTube, then people get two different opinions. Two points of views. That's what I want. I don't want players to just have one source and they think that's all there is. There ain't no more kind of thing. I want.
I don't know you.
Oh, that was weird what he
said.
You found
it. I've been looking for that blade for months. You took on all those bandits yourself?
Yeah.
Thank you. Here, my father had a favorite sword and shield technique. Let me teach it to you in honor of his memory. I can teach you a few things.
Okay, my neighbor decided to take a shower, so there's Hot water noise in the background.
Take care, friend.
I'm gonna see if I can use my video editor to filter out that noise, so we don't hear it right now at this moment in the video. I'll add that to my other filter, because I got two other filters. I got one for my my PC has a fan that makes a noise. I filter that out. Then my refrigerator makes a noise. I filter that out. It'll be a good experiment. Anyway, where are we now?
I serve Jarl Balgruuf. Excellent. You've done us a great service. Here is your reward.
What's that place called? Silent Moon? Anyway, I'm just racking up stuff. Collecting things, getting the bounties for things. Oh, we're doing this now.
This is a copy of a much older text. Perhaps dating to just...
I've got the,
After the Dragon War.
I've come back with the Dragonstone thing? Is that what I've done?
I'm glad you're making progress.
I can't remember.
My employers are anxious to have some tangible answers.
Oh, have no fear.
The timing here is very bad. I don't know if who wrote this quest here.
Time is running, Farengar, don't forget.
Because she says you have a visitor. And he's still yapping. So the timing's way off.
Yes, don't worry. Although the chance to see a living dragon up close would be tremendously valuable. Now, let me show you something else I found. Very intriguing.
See, he's still yapping away.
Employers may be interested as well. Hmm? Bah, yes, the Jarl's protege. Back from Bleak Falls Barrow. You didn't die, it seems. Ah, the Dragon Stone of Bleak Falls Barrow. Seems you are a cut above the usual brutes the Jarl sends my way. You'll have to see the Jarl about that. Maybe his steward, Avenici. I'm sure one of them will pay you appropriately. My associate here will be pleased to see your handiwork. She discovered its location by means she has so far declined to share with me.
So your information was correct after all. And we have our friend here to thank for recovering it for us.
You went into Bleak Falls Barrow and got that? Nice work. Just send me a copy when you've deciphered it.
Oh, that's right. Irileth shows up.
Farengar, you need to come at once. A dragon's been sighted nearby. You should come too.
Leave me alone.
A dragon? How exciting. Where was it seen? What was it doing?
I'd take this a bit more seriously if I were you. If a dragon decides to attack Whiterun, I don't know if we can stop it. Let's go.
We still have the companion with me? Is he going to come with us and kill a dragon?
We've got nothing to talk about.
Probably. We should be heading back to Yorvaskar. No, we haven't done Dustman Karns yet, have we? Yeah, I can't remember. It's been so long since I've gone through this footage. I'm like way past all this now in my playthrough.
Yes, my lord.
I can't remember how long ago I recorded this.
About the dragon.
Oh, that's right. We saw it coming from the south. It was fast. Faster than anything I've ever seen.
What did it do? Is it attacking the watchtower?
No, my lord. It was just circling overhead when I left. I never ran so fast in my life. I thought it would come after me, for sure.
Jarl Balgruuf is waiting.
We'll take it from here. Head down to the barracks for some food and rest. You've earned it. Irileth, you'd better gather some guardsmen and get down there.
I've already ordered my men to muster near the main gate.
Good. Don't fail me. There's no time to stand on ceremony, my friend. I need your help again. I want you to go with Irileth and help her fight this dragon. You survived Helgen, so you have more experience with dragons than anyone else here. But I haven't forgotten the service you did for me in retrieving the Dragonstone for Farengar. As a token of my esteem, I have instructed Avenici that you are now permitted to purchase property in the city. And please, accept this gift from my personal armory.
Come along. I would very much like to see this dragon.
No. Can't afford to risk both of you. I need you here working on.
I'm so glad that we're traveling to Eldegrins.
Of course.
Oh, that's right. For the longest time, she wanted me to take her to the cave.
One last thing, Irina.
Anytime.
This isn't a death or glory mission. I need to know what we're dealing with.
Don't worry, my lord. I'm the very soul of the. I'll see you at the watchtower as soon as the rest of the men have gathered.
I envy you the chance to see this dragon up close. You know, if you've got the aptitude, you should join the Mage's College in Winterhold. Come to Dragon's Reach to discuss the ongoing hostility. So, you wish to master the arcane arts.
Okay, usually by now I've got a bunch of stuff I can sell. Get rich. Unless Farangar is already out of money.
Remember, your mind is the best weapon you have.
Sounds like he is. He's only rich if I buy a whole bunch of crap from him. Maybe next time. Oh, come on, computer. You can do it. It's loading up all the 4K armors that I have for Whiterun. I still need to go and downgrade all the textures to 1K. From the Guard's Armor Replacer mod. Which has been updated now 4 times since I've installed it.
I don't like Nassim. He's self-righteous and patronizing.
Those
and he doesn't treat his wife very kindly.
Yes, what is it that you want?
The author may have already made some 1K textures for his guard's armor replacer.
Hello again, friend. Good day to you.
But he also did some other things.
Here's the situation.
Which I don't want to deal with in my playthrough.
A dragon?
So I'll do the downgrade myself.
I said a. I don't much care where it came from or who sent it. What I do know is that it's made the mistake of attacking Whiterun.
Because I got the. I got the guard replacement armor working with Cloaks of Skyrim. That took a bit to do. I don't want to have to deal that again. Cloaks of Skyrim is archaic. It's not compatible with the unofficial patches at all. You would think someone would update Cloaks of Skyrim to work with Usleep, but no, has not been done yet.
You're threatening our homes, our families. Could you call yourselves Nords if you ran from this monster? Are you going to let me face this thing alone? Let's move out.
I mean, she did quite the speech, as she always does. She always convinces these guys to go help her kill a dragon. We're so dead! Way off in the distance is a bandit, waiting for me to kill him. He'll have to wait.
Mind your...
I'm trying to get these guards to spread out so they're not all clumped together, back to back, tripping over each other's heels, but no, it doesn't look like that's a thing. The guards all wanna step on the backs of each other's heels, chasing after Irelith.
If you look around here, you
I wasn't seeing markers anywhere. And I think I accidentally turned off markers. If they're called floating markers? I'm not sure. I used to have them in my game until I reinstalled Skyrim from scratch. But I don't see a marker.
No where signs of any dragon right now.
Where am I supposed to stand?
Sure looks like he's been here. I know it looks bad, but we've got to figure out what happened. If that dragon sticks around. Spread out and look for survivors.
I just remember where to stand because I've done this so many times. So I know where to stand without seeing the mark. But I need to figure out how to turn the mark back on so I can see them in my game. I see them on the compass down below, I just don't see them suspended in midair in my face. That's weird how you only discover this place when it's burning. If you came here before, you never discover this place. Because they don't want you to fast travel here, ever, until much later in the game. Where is he? Man, that dragon was pretty bloody. It looks like its whole body was covered in blood, it looks like. Companion's still with us. Oh, I remember, yeah. I wanted to do a shout on somebody, but
I can't believe it.
I didn't know what my button was for shouting. I didn't set up all my buttons.
Tales, back from when there were still dragons in Skyrim.
For the gameplay menu?
And steal their power. That's what you did, isn't it? Absorb the dragon's power.
So I'll probably cut out like 15 minutes of this video because it took me 15 minutes to figure out where that is in the game where you tell Skyrim what button you use for shouting.
What are you talking about?
That's right. My grandfather used to tell stories about the Dragonborn. Those born with the dragon blood in them, like old Tiber Septim himself.
I've never heard of Tiber Septim killing any dragons.
There weren't any dragons then, idiot. They're just coming back now for the first time in forever.
But for the first time.
Could kill dragons and steal their power.
Who talks
you
like
must
that?
Be one.
You say you're left, being awfully quiet. Come on here, left. Tell us. Do you believe in this dragonborn business?
Their orange hair.
Some of you would be better off keeping quiet than
orange brown hair.
Thumbs on matters you don't know anything about. Here's a dead dragon, and that's something I definitely understand. Now we know we can kill them, but I don't need some mythical dragonborn. Someone who can put down a dragon is more than enough for me.
You wouldn't understand, House Khan. You ain't a Nord.
I've been all across Tamriel. I've seen plenty of things just as outlandish as this. I'd advise you all to trust in the strength of your sword arm over tales and legends.
If you really are Dragonborn, like out of the old tales, you ought to be able to shout. Can you? Have you tried?
I push the button and nothing happens. It's like, I'm pushing the button and nothing happens. So then I have to go in here and figure out where. Anyway, let me fast forward through all this.
That was shouting. What you just
what
did
of power is that?
Must be. You really are Dragonborn then.
Wow, I really did chop out 15 minutes of video before I found the right setting to do that. He was patient though to stand there while I looked up what button it was.
That was the hairiest fight I've ever been in. And I've been in more than a few.
That's a good shot right there.
I don't know about this Dragonborn business, but I'm sure glad you're with us.
Got the nice shading, lighting, blur going on in the background. Depth of field, whatever they call it. I was debating, should I go to Desmond's Karn or should I go to Dragon's Reach? So I can get Lydia, my new house Carl. What the heck? I'm curious what she looks like. You have to do all this before you find her in the game. Unless you use console commands, then you can. Oh, I totally forgot about that. I was like, earthquake. Someone's using the earthquake effect in the game. It's them damn Greybeards. Yeah, you can use console commands to introduce Lydia sooner than later in your game. Why not?
Why are you looking at me like that?
Have a copy of her
Didn't
in your game.
Didn't you believe that I could kill a dragon too?
Was my character smiling? Wow, that's rare. Usually he has a grim look. You have a grim look.